Hello everyone, welcome. It's Wednesday night, so it's time to get modern. Tonight, I'm playing a little game called Alan Wake, made by Remedy, circa 2010. This is basically the spiritual successor to the Max Payne series. It's not actually directly related to them, although it does have share some characteristics, quite a few actually, including some oddities. But it is made by the same people. It is a Xbox exclusive game. Well, I think it was also released on Windows 10 on the PC. Anywho, and it is actually quite an awesome game. This is a game that was not particularly well received. I'm not sure if it sold well or not, but it wasn't one of those games that a lot of people talked about back in the day or remember even now. But this is a game that's pretty much just a giant reference to Twin Peaks, really. That cult classic show from the 90s, early 90s, that I only seen like the first episode of, I wouldn't call myself an expert on that. But yeah, this is a third-person shooter made by the folks who made Max Payne. It's highly atmospheric. It's got some good stories, some good characters, some good atmosphere, some pretty good graphics, and some good gameplay, and I like it. It's one of my favorite games for the 360. If I had to make a top 10 360 games list, this would almost certainly be on it. Now I'm just gonna go into the options here to make sure that things are good. I'm gonna drop the music volume down a bit. Subtitles is enabled. Take a look at the controls. On foot, looks like we got not quite the left trigger, right trigger thing that shooters have nowadays, but it might end up being basically that way when you get down to it. It's sort of you'll see what I mean. Let's see, we got shoot, reload. Reload flashlight. Light is a very important thing in this game, as you will see. See, jump, move around, select weapons. I think there's some driving sequence, so I don't know if we're going to get to that, but we'll see. I think I even have the downloadable content for this as well, because I purchased Quantum Break, which is a game I intend on doing in my 4K sample series at some point in the future, and that came with this game for free, as well as all of its DLC and the expansion, Alan Wake's American Nightmare, which I'll probably do in a future episode of Modern Wednesday. This is Modern Wednesday, by the way, my weekly series I do on Wednesday night, where I play different modern games are different modern systems, typically Xbox 360, Xbox One, PS3, PS4, and if I had them, Wii U and Nintendo Switch. Let's see here. I'm gonna start up a new game. I'm gonna play it on normal. Yeah, I have beaten this game back in the day.
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic. And there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and is what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer.
Yep, Alan Wake is a writer. I am playing this on the Xbox One X via backwards compatibility, though I don't believe
had a vivid imagination.
This game is getting any enhancements of any kind.
It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream.
I do believe this game ran pretty well on original hardware, so
typical nightmare pattern.
I just did this for convenience,
late,
really.
Desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse, for some urgent reason. I couldn't remember. I've been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there.
Ah.
I'd
believe that's called a collision.
Too late.
You believe this is a dream sequence.
He was dead. I was convinced they put me in jail and I would never see Alice again.
He had a real number on his bumper there. And as you can see, the guy, the hitchhiker, is gone.
His body was gone. I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
All right. I do remember one of the criticisms made by Digital Foundry of playing this game on the Xbox One is that it is darker than it should be, at least compared to original hardware, and it kind of makes the game more difficult to see. Now, I don't know if they've patched this game to eliminate that problem.
I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
But I suspect that they did, because when I booted this game up for the first time in a while today, it had me download a 6 GB patch.
The bridge had collapsed. I'd have to find another way to the lighthouse.
Coffee thermoses, one of the collectibles in this game. Technically, it's the only pure collectible I think that this game has to offer. Is another story-related item that we'll be seeing eventually. What is this, Someone's missing here. Yeah, I can't read that name. Ah. Guy wielding an axe.
You don't even recognize me, do you, Ryder?
You think you're God? You think you just make up stuff? Play with people's lives and kill your fake ass to the drama? You're in this story now.
Starting to get a little stranger than fiction here, aren't we?
You missed your deadline!
Okay. Little dodge action here.
I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I've been working on.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
Okay, how about if we hold down LB to sprint? I doubt that we have unlimited sprinting ability here, so we just have to do the best we can. I'm hurrying there, mysterious guy. That's where we're running from, folks.
It's weak, it's me. I'm Stuart, remember? Wait. Oh no! Stop! No! Damn it, die! No! No! No!
Okay. Not his best day.
I was trapped. There was no way out.
Damn.
Yep, just like with the Max Payne games. Shows appearing on TV is definitely a reoccurring theme here.
Oh,
How do I get out of here?
Follow the light.
Okay, I'm low on health here.
You are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only safe there.
Alright. Presenting the save mechanic. Apparently the light heals us as well.
Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
Follow my light. I entered your dream to teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing.
Okay, something's entering my dream. Try to tell me something.
Over by the dark presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light. Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away.
Alright.
You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun.
Oh, you got a revolver here?
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
Taking over my dream to give me a little tutorial lesson.
You made me this way, and now I'm gonna kill you.
You can sort of do the old left trigger, right trigger in this with this game, but if you hold down left trigger all the way, you end up burning through your flashlight energy faster. But if you sort of hold it midway like this, you can focus your fire, your aim, while not using up any more electricity, any more battery energy, I mean, on the flashlight. And as long as you're shining the flashlight on enemies, it will slowly burn away their darkness. I'm using bunny ears with my fingers here. It will just not be as effective as it would be if you did this.
This is it, witch!
Ah. Ah, I should have dodged that. I definitely saw him. That's what I should have done. They explode into pillars of light there. This should be a checkpoint. We got a flare gun. The flare gun is pretty much the most powerful weapon in this game. It's basically the rocket launcher of Alan Wake. I don't think I'm supposed to be here.
Just like me.
because that's what it does. It vaporizes them. Light is a very key component of this here game. Oops. Not just the light from your flashlight, but also any source of light you can find. Whether they be portable lights or floodlights, lamps, anything that emits light is immediately something you want to gravitate towards. Funny, I remember when this game was being on previewed, that there was a lot of people who came away with the early impressions that this wasn't going to be a shooter of some kind, despite the fact that it's made by the people who made Max Payne. I guess some people expected this to be closer to like a Silent Hill, a non-combat oriented survival horror style game. I guess I kind of got that impression too, but thinking about it later, that doesn't make any sense. The people who make Max Payne made this game, and they make highly atmospheric shooters. And they have some elements similar to those types of games, the atmosphere and the style, but at the end of the day, it's still a third-person shooter developer. And that's what they made. They made a third-person shooter. Alright. Let's, look up into the light, I guess.
Just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
Yep. It was all a dream, folks. Not to worry. Definitely got some artifacting here in this pre-rendered cutscene. Some macro blocking, I believe the term is. Here we go, this looks much better. It may not come off on the stream very much, but I am watching this on a 4K TV, and you got that pre-rendered stuff, it definitely stands out.
Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear. Hi.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh?
Oh,
did you
dear.
Hear that,
huh? You have a lovely wife, if you don't mind me saying. I'm Pat Mayne, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I can get an interview?
Look, Mr. Mayne, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us.
He wants to keep it on the down low.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be this way. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
Spoiler alert, he's not going to keep his promise. All right.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. Made a friend. That's cute.
Right.
That's not condescending.
Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. That was my favorite writer. Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got him.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry. We're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you can relax.
Got ourselves a Lincoln here.
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Hey, just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
One of the things this game has been mocked for is its pretty obvious product placements.
What did I tell you?
Such as the fact that...
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Such as the fact that Alan Wake drives Ford branded cars and he uses Verizon branded cell phone. And also that he uses Energizer branded batteries for his flashlight. Alright.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord. A Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us.
Alright.
I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes.
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave.
Visiting the local diners.
Like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the Oh Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God. I am your biggest fan.
He didn't see his own poster of it.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment.
I can't believe it. I've got all of your books.
Yeah, okay.
I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
Right. So much for a quiet vacation.
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
Now, this game came out at the same time as another Twin Peaks-inspired game, roughly the same time. That would be Deadly Premonition, which was a game that Giant Bomb featured in an endurance run where they played through it a couple of different times, actually.
Or is your wife with you? I can show you the town if you want. I get off work at 6.
And the diner here
Thanks,
in this
Rose.
Game is very
we'll
similar
sure
to the diner in Deadly Premonition. So yeah, there's a lot of similarities in setting and tone and just, and obviously inspiration. I get the feeling that the more popular of the two games was Deadly Premonition. It was certainly the quirkier one. This game's
a
little more
favor,
generic
sonny.
In comparison.
I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
It does that. Get stuck. Yeah, you need to give it a good solid whack.
Okay.
Now that's what I'm talking about. Yes.
Now these two
this
guys will
it.
Be important
I've
later.
Died and gone to hell.
I think so. Oh, this song. Okay, I wonder if that's gonna get a content strike on my Alright, why don't we just move away from that?
Don't go in there. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am.
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stuckey, to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache.
overeager fans always did.
Hello?
Alright, so we're looking for a key here. Key to the cabin?
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill.
Hello, creepy lady.
But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
Okay. Creepy lady in
Calder
the black
Lake
morning
is a
dress.
Special place. Very inspiring.
Thank you. Leave
you got
the
lucky
dining.
This time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Splendid, splendid! Damn hernia. It swells up like a balloon if I lift anything heavier than a spoon. Yep. Splendid, splendid.
Wow.
It's been a long time.
Being old looks
gone.
Fun. I can't wait.
Good to see you.
The Andersons, they're, local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
All right. Eccentric locals at the diner. Bye-bye, crazy people.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
Wait. That's Stucky, then. Who?
That diner was a real...
Why was that lady who gave us... What's going on here?
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Yeah, guess what?
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand. Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
It's called Writer's Block.
And now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks in the big city might want to look up every once in a while and see those stars winking down at you. It gets pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
Cabin on the Lake. I hope this isn't going to get me a copyright strike. You never know.
Wow. It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
Alright. I assume there's a technical Latin name for fear of darkness. I sure don't know what it is. Bird leg cabin. Okay. Break a leg, I guess. I don't know. It's, certainly looks rustic.
Come on. Here we go. Let's take a look inside.
Mini game to unlock the door.
Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
Probably.
Hello? Anyone here?
The Deer Fest guests have already started to arrive. Just ran into one on the ferry. Famous artist, no less. We'll see if we can rope him into an interview later on. Now, let's go to the phones, caller. You're on KBF FM.
Hi, Pat. It's Rose.
Why, hello, Rose. What's on your mind?
I know who that famous artist was. It was Alan Wake, wasn't it? He's my favorite writer.
Well,
I just saw him at the diner. Oh, I am so excited he's here.
I guess he's not the one who spilled the beans.
I guess the
his caller, which I'm pretty sure he screened ahead of time, did.
Great. So much for keeping a low profile.
Yeah, he's still guilty in my opinion, but whatever. We need to get the power on.
The power cable goes to that shed over there.
Alright. To the shed. Had a button prompt there.
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again.
Alright. Looks like we have ourselves a generator.
Had been connected to the power cable.
Yeah, that's something you do a lot in this game, starting up generators to power lights. That is... That thing does not look safe at all. Do you see the way that thing is... wobbling like that? That does not look safe. But whatever, I guess if it's out here, away from the house, it doesn't really matter.
Okay, I'll look around a bit.
Sure thing. Have fun.
Yeah, like it's a game or something.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work.
I think your wife has other plans there, Alan.
I thought we could be happy here.
Checkpoint. What do we have here? We have an axe. I wonder if we're gonna have to grind it. An axe to grind? Get it? Ignore me, folks. I'm not worth listening to. Alright, let's look around to see if there's anything to see. Doesn't seem like it.
Alice? Honey? A shoebox filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I'd never heard of it before.
All right. From a technical perspective, this game probably doesn't hold up all that, doesn't seem to hold up all that well. It did come out in 2010, so it's almost 10 years old at this point. I'd say that the parts of it that will hold up will have more to do with the lighting and such than like the character details in the model. Geometry, complexity, or any of the textures and such. I suspect the lighting is where they put most of their effort and money into.
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
I already know what the surprise is, and I know that Alan's not gonna like it.
Surprise!
Alice? What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Yes, Alice, you... Everyone...
Hey, just hear me out. There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe... So now you want to get me committed?
No, it's not like that. That's not... Alan? Alan?
I don't, what just don't. I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice. God damn it! I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
It was a setup all along. This wasn't about getting away. This is about trying to get him to get back to writing.
Damn.
time.
Alice!
The cabin had gone dark. All the lights were out.
Okay.
Alice, I'm coming. It's all right. I'm coming.
Birds are attacking me for some reason.
Help me! Alice!
Yeah, I'm coming.
Alice? Alice?
What happened here? Uh-oh.
Oh no.
She done fell into the lake.
Keep going, Alice. Wake up.
Alice?
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice.
All right.
The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot.
You mean this Verizon-branded cellular phone is not working? Who would have thought? All right. Just like a Deadly Premonition, this game features a car crash.
Among Alice's things was a book. The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either.
It's pretty hard to put your face on the cover of a book and not have it be smug. Okay, at least I would imagine that's the case. I've never put my face on the cover of a book, so I don't really know. Alright, let's,
The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
Alright. Looks like we're heading to the gas station. I take it we can't go this way, right? No, that would be too easy. About to say that doesn't look that far away, but then I realize, oh wait. Goodbye, Lincoln. Is that a rental? I don't know if that'd make it better or worse if it was. A lot of foliage here. Yeah, one thing this game is not is an open world game. This is a very linear path. You're gonna follow this trail to your destination.
Hello?
And there's no question about where you should be going at any given point. Look at that.
Hello? Is someone there?
What's this?
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
That sounds foreboding.
Departure by Alan Wake.
Now this is going to include all the stuff that I had previously found.
The man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us. But the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare. But I was awake.
Awake, A-wake, Alan Wake, get it? Yep, I think I'm only missing one page from this, a couple pages from this area. 3 pages, alright. I suspect that the only ones that are going to show up are the ones I haven't collected. But the idea is that you find these manuscript pages throughout each level, and that is one of the collectibles. What makes it not a pure collectible item is that it actually does advance the story. It actually does tell you stuff. And many of these are sort of off the beaten path, so it pays to explore as you go. And the thermoses, on the other hand, which I found a couple, those are just purely collectible for collectible sakes. I imagine if you get all of them or a certain number of them, you'll get achievements associated with that.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Yeah, but shadowy, foggy guy disappears shortly after appearing.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
All right. Some litter and stuff. I should probably not spend too much time looking for manuscripts and thermoses. I do have the game to show off. Oops.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
If I see something, I'll grab it, but I'm not gonna spend too much time going out of my way to look for it.
Hey, you!
Failed!
There's been an accident! I need help!
Deposit.
I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Nightfall!
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable reservation.
The enemies have very similar speech patterns to what the enemies had in Deadly Premonition as well. Actually, not really. These are far more articulate than ooh, which is what they all sound like in Deadly Premonition. So, I just recently watched the Giant Bomb endurance run of that game. I guess it will still show the ones I have already collected. As a result, I do have Deadly Premonition on the mind. Not the reason why I chose this game for tonight, but I chose this because of its similarity to the Max Payne series.
Shit.
The deposit.
The latest thing!
Okay.
I had to figure a way out of this. Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
Energizer branded flashlight, not just batteries.
During your trying,
yes,
it's the latest.
Breakfall shot.
Hello? Hello?
Roman! Let you shoot!
What's going
on here? Okay, that's messed up. There goes that shed. Alright, Stucky, where are you? As you can see, there's a whole lot of fog.
The bulldozer had gone over the cliff with the office. I hoped Stucky had suffered the same fate, but I wasn't planning on staying to find out.
Lots of fog, lots of shadows, lots of lighting features. This is what I'm talking about in terms of the aesthetics of this game. This is one of the extra light sources. Occasionally, you'll see these arrows within the light pointing you in the direction of collectibles, of stuff you can find. Yes, I think this is the first instance in which
eerie hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near.
Not always collectible, sometimes it's actually useful stuff like that, so it's always worth checking it out. Ammo is not going to be as rare in this game as you would see in like a survival horror style game, but it's still, it's always good to pick it up whenever you can. Didn't seem to do anything there.
The dark forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
All right, you just threw an axe at me. As typical with these kind of games, I start out being very conservative with the ammo, taking as few shots as possible, striving for accuracy in my gunplay. But eventually, when things hit the fan, as it were, that goes out the window. Is that probably another manuscript I had previously collected? Yep. Still missing the same three pages I was. That's unfortunate. Wish it would only show the stuff I hadn't collected, but whatever. At least it gives you an idea of the frequency in which you find this stuff. You see, next to the flashlight and below my health bar, there's a little yellow dot indicating the direction I'm supposed to go. Basically, not quite a mini-map, but more of a compass. Flashbacks.
What the hell was that?
Yeah, I agree. What was that? Maybe it's because of the density of the foliage and all this stuff on the screen, but the game is looking a lot better now. I suppose it also helps that it's taking place at night. That's gotta help, right? Right? Anyway.
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
All right. Hit A to jump. Okay. There's another bad guy. He disappeared. Where did he go?
Still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
Getting lots of water in the coming out of the surround sound speakers here. I mean, the sound of water, not water actually leaking out of the speakers. That'd be messed up. And I should have dodged that. And I am just about out of ammo. Unless I'm mistaken, if you run out of ammo, you're kind of screwed because there's no melee attack in this game. Again, I could be mistaken, but I don't think I am. And you've seen, I've been pretty conservative with my ammo usage. Guess we go up there. Anyway, let me see here. Up here.
Taken. They're taken.
Who's taken? Alright, I got more batteries. That's not exactly what I was looking for, but I guess I'll take them. To be perfectly honest, I was looking for some ammo. Apologize if my if I sound a bit different, the volume levels on the mic sound a bit different. Unfortunately, the USB cable I was using actually broke, so I'm using a much shorter one, and as a result, the mic is in a different location than it would normally be. I'm gonna have to get a new USB cable for this thing, because the one I'm using right now is way too short for the job. Perfectly honest, I'm starting to wonder if the mic's picking me up at all. Can anyone hear me? Of course, if people were actually watching, they could answer, but whatever. Well, let's just press on, then. I don't know how long I'm going to be doing this tonight. I have a bunch of stuff I have to do tomorrow, so I'll probably end up turning in early.
My way up some other way.
All right. Is there ammo in here? Yes, there is. Thank you. It's like a revolver. You have to load each bullet individually. What do we have here?
There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
Finding a generator is a very common thing in this game. I did use 3 shots on one of those guys, so I was a little bit wasteful there. Now, you have the ability to reload your flashlight with batteries. when you're doing this a lot, and it's helpful for that in dire, sticky situations, but batteries will recharge on their own.
With all this forestry equipment around, there had to be something I could use to reach the top.
Left over from back in the day when everything had to be a minigame. Or a QTE sequence of some kind. No, that's not one of the missing pages. But I'll definitely take that. And then immediately unequip it because we don't really need it at the moment. Is there anything else, though? Just like the Max Payne games, this is definitely one of those games where you want to look around every nook and cranny to find stuff. This may not be an RPG where you're collecting loot or anything like that, but ammo and batteries are both highly desirable. There is no equivalent of painkillers or any health items in this game. I don't think so. We'll find out. Anyway, let's go to the yellow dot. Looks like it did something useful. We got locked and loaded, so let's climb this ladder and see what happens. Jump a couple times. I imagine if there are any kind of exploding barrels in this game, that those would also be effective against these enemies with the amount of light that they give off. See? Floodlights like this serve as checkpoints, and they also give you health back.
Well, I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along.
The only guy in this radio station?
No,
does he do this all day?
Nights like this, I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild. But here I am, and who'd keep you company all night long if I weren't? It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, Pat, it's Maurice Horton.
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
Well, I was just taking Toby on his walkies.
Oh, isn't it beautiful out there?
Sure, but Pat, the reason I called is that Toby heard something rustling in the undergrowth and took off after it, and I couldn't find it.
Probably a rabbit.
Sure. Toby loves rabbits.
Well, sure. And Toby's a friendly dog?
Oh, Toby loves people. Usually he comes back, but we were pretty far from home, and it sounds like he went pretty wild there.
All right.
Great dog, but
he's
up for his own good.
Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon.
Yeah, thanks, Dad.
You have a good night now.
Yeah, poor Toby. Are you feeling sympathy for a dog in a video game that I haven't even seen yet? That's me for you. That's how the pros do it. Okay. Nope. Chances are the three pages I'm still missing are so far off the beaten path I'll never find them in this playthrough.
Paul, man,
Okay. Talking about hot dogs, I presume. I saw a I managed to hit the dodge button in time for that. There you go. Safe haven. All right. In this game, it's usually a good idea to head towards the light. Ah, that guy got me. Collect another manual script, but it's not one of the ones I'm missing. Oh well. Keep hoping in vain that it's going to be the one, but so far that hasn't been the case. It just hasn't. All right. There's a checkpoint. I'll take that. Anyway, let's go this way. Got an arrow pointing me in the opposite direction of my indicator. Which means there's probably something worthwhile here. Look at that. More flare gun ammo. I'll definitely take that. You saw how effective that was against those crazy guys earlier, so getting more ammo for that thing is definitely worth my while, I would say. Okay. Pretty sure I was hitting the left bumper button. Okay. And that's how I died. I got screwed up there. Alright, let's see if we can do better with that. Thankfully, it was close to a checkpoint. Instead of wasting time being indecisive about using the flare, I should have just been shooting. Heck, I even have a shotgun I could have used in that situation. Yep, you're gonna move. That's how you handle that. Ignore my failed attempt the first time. That doesn't count. That's a mulligan, let's say. I highly doubt that this is going to be one of the ones I've missed. No, it's not. I'll definitely take that.
Science. It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan, princes among men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. In Night Springs.
I believe this is a spoof of the Twilight Zone.
If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate.
Obviously, the production quality on these little videos have gone up substantially from still images to actual video.
I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so many of you could join me here at the Moorcock Institute. Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation. As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment. And now, a real experiment, known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, stay calm. There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet, I myself cannot be harmed with this gun.
Okay.
With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is...
Ah, something got unplugged.
Did not happen here.
You're insane, Colvin.
Insane? Insane?
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools! Gaze upon quantum immortality.
Okay.
Poor Dr. Colvin. Felled by his own hubris or the ignorance of the masses. Perhaps he should have left the crate unopened, the decaying atom unobserved. Curiosity often kills the cat in Night Springs.
Well, that guy didn't have a good end. Even in dire circumstances like this, there's no reason not to pause for a moment and watch a little TV. I guess we have all the batteries that we can carry. The Energizer people are going to be so disappointed to hear that I'm not using their batteries. Hey, look. Yeah. All right. Checkpoint. Plenty of revolver ammo there for some reason. This is a very heavily armed lumber camp. Oops, let's not go off the cliff, shall we? I'm gonna get killed plenty in this game for legitimate reasons. Let's not add a dumb reason on top of that. Hello.
Oh no.
Okay, this is not a good situation to be in. Yay! That was the end of Stucky there.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice.
Okay. Glad you recognize it, because I don't.
After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself.
Gave me a checkpoint, I'll definitely take that. But it's not giving me my missing pages.
The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
Eek. That's gnarly.
The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
All right. I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel a presence.
Hey, look.
Just
another
now,
TV.
I can smell the perfume in the room.
Cool,
I'll
huh?
Reach her, fix up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
Look at this. Fragile. Okay, that's dumb. Nordic walking. Incontestably proven health benefits. Alright. Don't forget the legendary Deerfest parade, I guess. I'm gonna go out on a limb and say I probably will forget it. Is there a phone here? And look at that. Look at that.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please,
what?
I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen.
We'll figure this out.
Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
All right, camera's panning out. Is this an opportunity for a late title card? Oh, is that a cabin in the lake? The cabin on the island in the middle of the lake never existed, apparently. That's interesting.
Tiptoes to my room every night, and just a sprinkle stardust and a whisper.
End of episode
go
one.
To sleep. Everything is all right. I close my eyes.
All right, why we hit
previously
skip?
On Alan Wake, I came to Bright Falls with my wife, Alice.
Thank See if we can avoid any
I thought maybe you
copyright
could
strikes here.
God damn it, Alan.
Now, she's missing.
Alice? Alice?
I woke up behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at. But the cabin had disappeared.
The plot thickens. Now we're going back 3 years in. New York City. Just in case you need another connection to the Max Payne series, there it is. Look at that. He's in New York.
Honey, I'm home.
Back here, sweetie. How was it?
Worst weather I've ever seen.
You should put some coffee on. It'll warm you up.
I assume that's a coffee maker.
Coffee's
got a
on.
Fancy one.
Great, thanks. I'll need it if I'm gonna finish this by tomorrow.
Benefits of being a rich writer is that you have a whole bunch of nice things in your house. Guess you can just call that the benefits of being rich. Writer or not. Alright, there's 4 missing pages in this section. Return to sender. Return to sender. Wasn't that one of the names of... Wasn't that the name of one of the TV series in Max Payne 2? I know. There's Dick Justice, Lords and Ladies. I don't know. Toilet. Should be a mirror there. Why wouldn't there be? That's odd. We looked at that. Getting some staticky, something staticky going on. What's...
Oh, hey, I just finished those cover mock-ups. They're on your desk. Tell me what you think.
No kidding. I didn't think you'd get them done this quickly.
On occasion, I can perform all sorts of miracles, my dear.
Oh, really?
She's some sort of photographer, editor. I don't know. Yeah, let's go on the deck if we can. Nope. Got a little bit of dithering there. That's right, dithering. It's not just on the Sega Genesis anymore. What? All right, go to the desk. Got it.
These look really good.
Oh, sure, until Barry gets his hands on them. Which, by the way, will happen over my dead body. The last time was the last time. Oh, and speaking of Barry, he called. Alan?
Alan, please check the fuse box.
I'm right here. I'm on it, honey.
Please, hurry!
I'm right here, baby.
I'm fine. Just
honey, it's a power outage. I've got the flashlight.
Okay. Hi.
You okay?
I'm sorry. It just really spooked me.
Don't worry. We'll just break out the candles.
Candles are fun.
I know, it's stupid, but it's just... especially when I'm not prepared for it, you know? It gets to me.
I love you.
Is anyone really prepared for a power outage?
Okay. I used to have these nightmares when I was a kid. The dark really spooked me, too. When it got really bad, my mom gave me this old light switch. She called it the clicker.
The clicker, huh?
Yeah. If I ever got scared of the dark, I could just flip the switch and a magic light would scare the monsters away.
Oh, sure.
Here it is.
Alan.
Maybe it'll help you too.
Yeah, nice story, writer boy. You made that up right now, didn't you?
No. Seriously.
I love you, even if you are a liar. Thanks for this.
Looks like the same kind of snowfall that was in Max Payne 1. Wright Falls, present day.
How do you feel, Mr. Wick? Any nausea, disorientation, anything like that? Mr. Wick, how are you feeling?
I'm okay. My head's fine. I had to lie about my headache and memory loss. He'd send me to a hospital for tests. I couldn't leave without Alice.
Very well. I don't think you have a concussion, but you've obviously been through quite a shock. You should take it easy for a couple of days.
Thanks.
Well then, Mr. Wake, we're done here. If the pain gets any worse or you experience any other symptoms, you should come see me. I'll let you get on with it then. Sarah, Sheriff Breaker, is waiting for you. She's very good at her job. I'm sure she can locate your wife in no time.
Doc Nelson was the image of a small-town doctor. Sheriff Breaker had called him to the station to take a look at the cut in my head.
Look at that computer. Clicky-clacky keyboard, 5.5-inch floppy drive, disk drives, 2 of them, in fact. Probably the kind of person who thinks he can get away with still having something like that, even in 2010. Funny because he has a much more modern computer over here.
I believe you'll find the sheriff in her office. Just go down the corridor.
I'm sorry you had to cut your morning fishing short for this, Doc.
Oh, she's a beauty, ain't she? Not the biggest I ever caught, if you can believe that coming from an old fisherman like me, but she's right up there. Now, she's a largemouth bass, which is what you're after if you prefer a lure. Now, if you want either trout or salmon, on the other hand, then it's fly fishing for you. You're good to go, Mr. Wake. Sarah's probably waiting for a chance to talk to you.
Okay. Alright. Let's go see Sarah then, I guess. So we are in a police station, not a hospital.
Thank you for testing the lights, Miss Weaver. Everything seems to be fine.
I don't have the luxury of being complacent, Deputy Grant. The bulbs will need changing soon. You can't change them in the dark.
I'll be sure to take care of it, Miss Weaver. Have a nice day now.
Very good. I'll come back later on to remind you, just in case.
Ah, she's the one who warned me about walking in the dark.
The sheriff is waiting for you in her office down the corridor.
Local loon.
That was Cynthia Weaver. I guess you can call her the town eccentric. She used to be the editor of the local newspaper, but she's focused on, other things these days.
She'd fit right in where I come from.
As you can see, she's a little obsessed with maintaining the light bulbs of the whole town, refuses to step on shadows, things like that. Back in her day, she wrote about all sorts of weird things in the paper. Bright Falls has a colorful history. Of course, what small town hasn't?
All right. Is this a manuscript I hadn't picked up yet? Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, nope. The odds are always low of that, but I wanted to make sure.
Yeah, it's Mulligan here. I'm at Stuckey's gas station with Thornton. There's no sign of him. Over.
Wait. Yeah, this is Thornton. Look, we've located the parade float. It's here. That's some good news, right? Stucky was supposed to be driving it at the rehearsal today. Over.
Oh, give me that. Mulligan here. Looks like someone really thrashed the garage. Over.
Okay, roger that, guys. Keep looking for Stucky. Jane's out.
All right.
The sheriff wants to see you in her office, Mr. Wake.
Oh, we should probably head over this way then. Okay, got some missing persons there. They're not interested in letting me interact with random objects as much as they were in Max Payne and Max Payne 2. I can't just make the water cooler bubble like you know I want to. Alright,
Come in, Mr. Wake. Your phone's on the desk. The battery was dead. It's charged now.
Have you started looking for my wife yet?
My men are already on it. Now, can you tell me what happened?
I'm not sure. I can't remember. We were arguing. I walked out of the cabin.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? How did you end up at Stucky's gas station?
I wanted to tell her what had happened last night, but I couldn't. She'd locked me up. Excuse me. I need to take this. Hello? Alice?
Stop talking to the law. You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife again.
Who is this?
Go to the back lot. There's a hole in the fence on the left. Look inside the junker. I left a little something there to convince you we're all on the same page here. After you ditch the cops, you're gonna meet me in Elderwood National Park. There's a spot called Lover's Peak. Midnight.
Mr. Wake, can I help you with anything?
We're watching you.
I need to get some air. The sheriff said I could go out back.
Of course, Mr. Wake. You can gather through the cell corridor.
Hey, mister! Hey, can you turn the light? The light's on! The deputies, they don't understand. They won't listen.
Thank you, man. Thank you. Hey, you're all right. You're a good guy. Don't let anybody tell you different.
All right. Yeah, that's not one of the four missing pages, is it? No. Always good to keep checking. Just in case. I guess I was more thorough in finding them than I thought.
I hurt my eyes and made my head ache. The man on the phone had said, go through the fence on the left.
Hey, look. A thermos.
Well, folks, it's been another long night, and it's about time for me to sign off for a while. God knows I need my beauty sleep. Just one more item before I go. It's been a busy night for the sheriff's department. We've had a few broken windows, even a report of shots fired on Main Street. Deputies Mulligan and Thornton had to deal with two intoxicated young men who were celebrating the completion of their Deer Fest float. Now, folks, we get this every year. I know it's exciting, the big day is almost here, but let's save it for the party and leave the gunplay for the shooting competition, huh? There's no point in getting all worked up yet.
Yeah, this town is really into this Deer Fest thing. Look, Ford. Fusion.
The caller had told me to find a hole in the fence behind the police station. There was something for me in an abandoned car.
This must be that hole in the fence. No. I'm gonna keep checking it every time I get one.
Alice's driver's license had been placed on the front seat. The caller meant business.
Barry?
Ow, ow, thank God! Where the hell have you been? I've been trying to reach you for a week, you and Alice. I've been worried sick. I flew out yesterday. I'm here in Wright Falls.
Barry, listen to me. I'm at the sheriff's station. Come and get me. I can't talk now.
Ow, what the hell is going?
I had to get the sheriff to let me go. I needed to get to Elderwood National Park to meet Alice's kidnappers.
Okay. I guess we go back into the station then.
A writer is a light that reveals the world of his story from darkness, shapes it from nothingness, the way a sculptor carves a statue from a block of granite. If I stop, the world I'm making dies. Darkness will reclaim it. It's a long, hard journey into the dark. Alice's life is at stake, but I can't think about that, or I'll lose it. The dread lingers at the edge of perception. I'll push on. Anything is possible here. I'll write the story. I'll save her.
As we all know from psych class, perception is reality. Right? Right? Still not entirely sure that this mic is even picking me up.
Marvelous, sir. I just wanted to settle all the damage the Anderson brothers might have inadvertently caused on their recent and regrettable little outing. They are not accountable for their actions, of course. I can assure you that my staff has been reprimanded.
That voice sounds very familiar.
Owen never caused any trouble to anyone when they were still living at their farm.
The guy's voice sounds very familiar.
All we can do is to slow down the progress of their dementia.
Are you feeling any better, Mr. Wake?
I'd like to leave. Am I free to go?
Well, we still need to talk about...
Am I under arrest?
No, of course not. But I need to know where you'll be staying so I can get in touch with you.
I'd avoid the motel. The Majestic is known for its roaches. The cabins at Elderwood are pretty nice, though.
That sounds perfect.
I'm Dr. Emil Hartman. I'd like to invite you to stay at Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Did you talk to my wife?
I had the pleasure of discussing your situation with her on several occasions.
Did you set something up with her?
I invited her here. My clinic is a place where...
Oh, hey! Oh, my!
Take it easy.
Hey, nobody move. Get your hands off of my client.
Who are you?
I'm Barry Wheeler, his agent. If you have business with Mr. Wake, you talk to me. You yokels won't know what hit you once I sick my lawyers on your asses.
No harm done, Sarah. I'm all right. I don't want to press charges. Mr. Wake, my offer still stands.
Clearly,
get me out of here.
Alan Wake is not interested in your offer, good sir.
What the hell was that about, Al? We don't need a replay of that thing with the paparazzi. I thought they were gonna lock you up.
I had to talk to someone. I told Barry everything. He thought I was certifiable, but when he heard about the manuscript, I had him. The fact that I'd written something, even if I couldn't remember it, was enough for him. He smelled money. And he believed that Alice had been kidnapped. Anything beyond that was another story. I had a midnight appointment with the kidnapper in a place called Lover's Peak, somewhere in Elderwood National Park.
That's not a Ford.
Rent a cabin.
I don't like it, Al. I don't like any of it. It's not good. In fact, it's the absolute opposite of good.
That sounds like the same voice actor who did Vinny Gottinini in the Max Payne series.
Oh, wow. I was just thinking about you, too.
Great.
I was just bringing Rusty some coffee. He's on the balcony, looking after Max. Poor thing. I really need to go. Great to see you again, Mr. Wake. Later!
Who's Max?
Good question.
What an airhead.
Jeez, Mr. takes a swing at everybody. This is not her fault. She's a very nice girl and, more importantly, a fan. She even has a fan site dedicated to you. And she was very helpful when I was looking for you. Seriously, Al, what you were saying in the car? Just listen to yourself. What, you shot a guy and his body just disappeared? When was the last time you slept? What, are you high? Have you been drinking?
No! Look, Barry, I'm missing a week, and someone's got Alice, and everything's just—
Do you understand what it sounds like when you say stuff like that? Don't get me wrong, it's a good story, could be a bestseller. But when you start confusing fiction with reality, you're buying yourself a ticket to the funny farm.
All right, wait here.
Look at this heavy-duty espresso machine. Two brew heads. Where's the where's the grinder, though? Is that it? No, it's just a regular coffee machine. Why do you grind the coffee in this place? Yes, that's the kind of detail I notice. Yeah, a stand mixer that kind of looks like that. Anyway, Sorry, I'm just a little tired here. I managed to start the stream on time, even though I actually got out of work a half hour later than usual. Good thing the freeway was pretty much empty. Let's see here. Is this the way? Yeah, look at that. I found the way, almost as if I knew where I was going.
Easy there, boy. I'm almost done.
Hey, Rusty, Donkey. Right? You're at Cabot's.
Oh, Mr. Wake. I'd shake your hand, but mine are kind of full here. Actually, I'm sorry about this. Would you mind grabbing the registration form from the desk? It's just across from Bucktooth Charlie.
Okay, sure. What happened?
Crazy poachers. Max here got his foot caught in a trap. They're illegal to use here. Hell, you're not supposed to hunt within the park at all. But that doesn't stop some lowlifes. Well, at least Max is going to be okay. He got lucky.
Poor doggy.
Max is still groggy from the shot I gave him, and I'd rather not leave him alone just yet. The form's on the desk across from the map.
Seriously, Al, you can't just go and meet a kidnapper. Those situations always end up in disaster. You gotta talk to the cops.
She's my wife, and it's my call. Can we talk about this later?
No. This whole thing... Listen, you hit your head. I mean, geez, Al, come on. You gotta understand how crazy all this sounds. If you're trying to pull a joke on me, freak me out, it's working. Ha ha, let's have a laugh on Barry. Well, you had me going there real funny, Al. You can quit it now.
So clearly, Barry, my agent, and supposedly my friend, doesn't believe me. That's great. That's wonderful.
I think this is the form you wanted.
And here are the keys. Okay, you're all set, Mr. Wake. Glad to have you staying here.
Thanks. Can you tell me how to get to Lover's Peak?
Oh, sure. It's at the end of the nature trail. Just follow the paths you'll get to eventually. It's an easy walk. Nice spot, too.
All right.
If you have any trouble finding it, just keep your eyes on the radio mast. It's right below that. Oh, and hey, if you take a walk in the woods, watch your steps so you don't end up like Max.
I guess I'm a little worried. We got a bunch of campers out there we haven't heard from. It's not like these people are on a schedule, but with the traps, well, you know, I just don't want any trouble.
Okay, that's a messed up thing to have to worry about. Bear traps. I've played Limbo. I know what bear traps do to people.
You're
they cut your heads off.
You're asking me to believe that you shot a dude who went poof into thin air, a guy who was bulletproof until you pointed a flashlight at him. You hear that from people who end up spending time in padded rooms, strapped to their beds, wearing white shirts with too long tangled up sleeves, and eating a healthy diet of pills.
I don't know. I think he believes
Al,
me.
You make cruel jokes.
Anyone
about
who's selling
who
me this hard
kind of
on how
stuff.
He doesn't believe
You're
me, he's gotta be a believer.
You gave me an hour-long lecture on homeopathy last month. What was it? If there's no proof, it's pure bullshit. Period.
Guess the laugh's on me then.
Al, come on! I mean, okay. Okay, maybe something weird happened to you, okay?
Well, thanks for the heartfelt vote of confidence.
All I'm saying is you gotta throw me a bone here, bestseller.
Here's
what
a bone.
What would you think if it was me? There's no way you should be going out at midnight with a gun.
No one asked you to come here, Barry. Either work with me on this or go straight back to New York. Your choice.
The reluctant agent in this case. Reluctant friend, reluctant sidekick.
We should go to the sheriff or call the FBI.
Damn it, Barry. They'll kill her.
This is not a goddamn debate, Barry.
Who's he?
I'm going to Lover's Peak. He said to come alone.
Okay then. I understand. You're my best friend, and I'm worried that you're not right in the head. Tell me what to do to help, and I'll do it.
You stay here, and if I'm not back by morning, call the cavalry.
And the cavalry would be... Yeah, he's clearly a city guy.
Just be careful with the natives, Al. These yokels are dangerous. Everybody hates a tourist, or it'll be deliverance all over again.
I've never seen deliverance. I've heard it was bad, though.
Oh, this place is trying to kill me.
I don't know.
I bet there's mold in here, spores, poison ivy, God knows what. This is so not worth a 15% commission.
There's plenty of that in New York there, buddy. That isn't just the exclusive property of the Pacific Northwest, you know. Doesn't exactly look like there's any power here. Oh wait, never mind. There totally is. This is a pretty nice cabin. Honestly, this looks suspiciously like the cabin that supposedly doesn't exist. Ooh, batteries. Where were they? Here they are. Wait, I was carrying a lot more batteries than that. Hey, guess what? My gun is gone as well. Great. A cabin with a stand mixer? That seems unlikely. Alright. Nice views. I even believe I'm gonna take a look around. You never know when you might find a thermos or a manuscript page. Also useful stuff like ammo, or perhaps a weapon, a gun, a revolver. There's plenty of useful things to be found if you just look.
I'll wait here, Al. I'll hold down the fort. I'll be with you in spirit every step of the way, Al. Lock the door now.
Good job, Barry. You do that. Yeah, there's like no chance of that being the missing one of the four missing ones. Not one that easily found. I guess that's the thing. If it's something I can find now, chances are it's something I found already.
I knew I should have gone to the cops. This wasn't the smartest thing I'd ever done, but I was still angry with Barry for trying to talk me out of it. These people had called me right in the sheriff's station. The cops wouldn't scare. And they had Alice.
It's funny, I could have sworn we saw Alice fall down into the lake. The lake surrounding that island with the cabin that doesn't exist. Speaking of cabin, this one right there. Can we go in there? Ah, cheap scares. No doubt heightened by the surround sound system.
Welcome back to the show, folks. As promised, our very own Dr. Nelson has just parked his rear end in the studio. Doc,
What's your dear fest plan? My plan? You make sound a lot more organized than I ever seem to manage. No plan, really. Just taking the atmosphere. I'm getting a little too rickety to do much more than that, you know.
Yeah, right.
Don't tell me about it. No sack race for us older gentlemen, huh? Yes,
couple
exactly,
of old
man.
People chit-chatting on the radio.
Parade, of course, and I'll be one of the park on.
I wonder what they're chit-chatting so about.
Well, that takes a different kind of constitution. Oh yeah, it's my kind of exercise. Now, Doc, seriously, you're in pretty good shape, though. You're the outdoors type. I know for a fact you're an avid fisherman.
That's right. Matter of fact, just caught a heck of a largemouth bass early this morning.
But you're not taking part in the fishing contest?
No, not this.
Well, folks,
see, Pat,
I think I'm going to call it a day. Yeah, I've been streaming for about 2 hours now.
Piece of it. It's no fun if I need to worry.
Sorry if I'm cutting it off a little bit early tonight, but I do have to get up a little early tomorrow to get some stuff done. I think I have to go into work early as well. In any case, thank you for watching. I've been playing Alan Wake here for the Xbox 360 on the Xbox One via backwards compatibility. Just as a quick reminder, I do a retro stream on Monday night, typically at about 8 o'clock. A modern stream on Wednesday night, typically at about 11 o'clock or a little bit later if I get home from work late. And I do a 4K and or HDR upload on Friday, with occasional other streams throughout the week if I get the time and the energy to do so. But yeah, like I said, thank you for watching. This has been Alan Wake. It's a pretty good game. I'd recommend it to anyone who has an Xbox One or 360. You can get it cheaply. My physical copy is not really being used right now because I got it for free when I got Quantum Break, which I'll feature at some point in the future. And yeah, like I said, thank you for watching, and until next time, take it easy.